Hello friends, welcome to Pro Talent and I am Nitin Parmar. Today we are discussing about misuse of security law. I am sure आप सब लोग ये करंट अफेयर के इस मॉड्यूल्स जो कैप्सूल मॉड्यूल्स है उनको पसंद कर रहे होंगे. इफ यू हैव एनी सजेशंस ऑन इट फील फ्री एंड टेल अस सो दैट वी कैन पॉसिबली गिव यू कंटेंट इन योर पर्सपेक्टिव. ओके सो दोस्तों वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट अगेंस्ट ए नेशनल सिक्योरिटी लॉ. व्हाई आर वी टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस? व्हाई वाज इट इन द न्यूज? बिकॉज अलाहाबाद हाई कोर्ट सेड दैट द मैलिफिक मैनर इन विच Dr. Kafil Khan was detained under National Security Act, that is not acceptable. Okay, from there, we are discussing about the misuse of the act called National Security Act 1980, which is primarily preventive detention law. Okay, now that is acceptable. My dear students, preventive detention is acceptable for any country. Or rather, people do not even understand what is preventive detention, like UK, USA. But in India, we need this preventive detention that this person may possibly commit something wrong. Okay, something wrong in future, and thereby we want to stop him today. That is what preventive detention is. Anyway, what is this NSA? It is National Security Act. It was launched by Indira Gandhi primarily to detain any person who will be termed as a threat to national security, sovereignty and law and order of the nation. There is a kind of maximum detention of 12 months. So that means any central government or a state government can put this person into jail for 12 months. Now that becomes big challenge. So here we have to understand that why Dr. Kafil Khan was put behind the bar, in what manner he was put behind the bar. Let's understand that Dr. Kafil Khan addressed the students of Aligarh Muslim University in December 2019. He gave a speech on Citizenship Amendment Act, and it was alleged that the speech was inflammatory. The speech contained lot of hatred. There is a tendency of violence in it. This was an allegation. He gave a speech in December 2019 and he was arrested on January 29, 2020. Shortly after, he was granted a bail. So he was arrested in January 29, 2020. On this speech, so he asked for a bail. He was given a bail, okay, and he was detained under NSA on February 13, 2020. He was detained under NSA after he was granted bail in an earlier case. Okay, this is how the scenario took place. So in 2017, earlier case of Kafil Khan came into picture, but he was given, you can say, a kind of bail even at that point in time. He was a doctor. He was a government doctor in one of the, you can say, Gorakhpur hospital. And at that point in time, due to shortage of oxygen cylinders, few children died. Okay. And thereby, there was a charge of negligence and corruption against him. Okay. Here, the case facts, you can say, are telling us that he took lot of efforts to ensure that there is a continuous supply of oxygen, but still there was a charge of negligence and corruption. He spent months in jail before the inquiry absolved him from charges of negligence and corruption. So he was removed from those charges. Okay, then this once again a new case came in. So here we have to understand what is the right available through our constitution to everyone, every citizen of this country. Article number 22 is saying that protection against arrest and detention. So there are two parts in it. Part one talks about that rights on a person who is arrested and detained under an ordinary law. So he has right to be informed on the ground of arrest, right to consult and be defended by legal practitioners, right to be produced before magistrate within 24 hours, and right to be released after 24 hours unless the magistrate authorizes. Remember, here, article number 22, the first part provides specific rights to person under punitive detention. Remember, not under preventive detention, punitive detention. Punitive detention is a detention of a person after a trial and conviction to punish him for an offense committed by him. So it is basically for punishment purpose. Okay, so that is the first part. Why are we giving this kind of rights? To provide safeguard. Remember, these safeguards are not available to enemy alien. That means these safeguards are available to citizens, number one, or it is not available to a person arrested or detained under preventive detention law. Remember this. So NSA may possibly fall into this category. Supreme Court held that arrest and detention in Article 22 do not cover arrest under order of a court, civil arrest, arrest due to failure or to pay income tax, deportation of an alien. So there are certain proven things for that. Article number 22 is not provided. So this kind of rights are available. I'm sure you understand that these are the fundamental right. This kind of rights are available to the criminal or quasi-criminal, you can say, activities. Okay. So what is a preventive detention? Now Article 22 part 2 refers to preventive detention. Preventive detention is the arrest of a person to prevent him from committing further crime. So if a person is restricted, okay, he's been disabled to do further crime, that is what you can say preventive detention is. Remember, this you can say detention, that is preventive detention, are also covered in Article number 22. Okay. So preventive detention ke mutabik provisions kya hai? Person is detained on the ground of suspicion shall be detained for a maximum period of, you can say, 3 months. If the government seeks to detain person, to detain the person arrested beyond the 3 months, then they have to, you can say, get authorized approval from an advisory body. To ye sab cheeze unke saath hoti nahi hai. Theek hai? Problem ye hai. Okay, so that way, these are the challenges. Remember, there is a difference between punitive detention and this is preventive detention. Preventive detention is without trial. Punitive detention is with a trial. Remember that it is through trial and prosecution and conviction. Okay, remember that. So this is basically a difference. Okay, you can very well get this PDF on protalanddigital.com to get more details about this article number 22. So these are few of the laws in our country jiske bare mein aaj bada halla ho raha hai. For example, Preventive Detention Act 1950, APSPA, Armed Forces Special Power Act, wo kahan pe hai? So you know Jammu Kashmir, Assam, Nagaland, Mizoram. So there are few states where APSPA is available. So let me give you a homework question. In how many states in our country or union territory where APSPA is applicable? Okay. So this is what you have to answer. In the comment section, there is UAPA, Unlawful Activities Amendment and Prevention Act. Okay. Then you have COFEPOSA. You had earlier MISA, which is now repealed. MISA was a law which was brought in during emergency time. So I'm sure you know emergency ke liye abhi kaafi ladaiyan chal rahi hai. Yes or no? So emergency came in Indira Gandhi's time. Now it is being demanded that usko unconstitutional bol dijiye. Yes or no? So there is a demand which is coming up. So ye MISA ki wajah se Lalu Prasad Yadav went to jail and during that time he had a daughter born. So उन्होंने अपनी daughter का नाम ही Nisa रख दिया था. National Security Act जिसके बारे में आज हम बात कर रहे हैं. Okay, we are discussing about this. You can say NSA. We have, you can say TADA, which is repealed now. We have POTA, which is removed now. So TADA, हमारे संजय दत्त, you can say जेल में गए थे. So what did Allahabad High Court say? The court found that the speech does not disclose any effort to promote hatred or violence. ठीक है? It nowhere does it threaten the peace in Aligarh. Okay, so that is one very important point being provided by the Allahabad High Court. It says district magistrate of Aligarh used selective reading, used only some of the phrases, and thereby he put that into detention, which is not acceptable. At the same time, the grounds for detention provided nothing that indicated any attempt by Dr. Khan to disturb peace and tranquility between this December 2019 and the detention took place in 2020. So basically, we are giving a speech, and let's say someone is alleging that the speech may create hatred, may create violence, so it should create violence. ठीक है, he gave a speech in December 2019, nothing happened till February 2020, which clearly tells that his speech was not, you can say, giving any hatred. So the inference is that NSA was invoked only to avoid releasing him following Chief Judicial Magistrate's court order granting him a bail. So there was a bail was granted. After that bail was granted, this NSA was invoked. So that means it is a clear case of misuse of security law. The process to invoke NSA itself began only after the bail order was provided. Thereby, the bench said that it is wrong. It is definitely wrong. So what is unacceptable? The court said that the use of stringent national security laws against political dissenter in the absence of any appeal to violence should be condemned in all cases. If you can say such kind of dissent leads to violence under NSA, that person may be put behind bar, but there is no violence, then why? However, there is also unacceptable part about the resort to preventive detention to frustrate bail orders. So whatever the bail order came to frustrate the entire order, the NSA preventive detention was provided. That is also not acceptable in any scenario. So here authorities have shown excessive zeal to arrest Dr. Khan. He had to spend 7 months in a jail, and thereby this is really not acceptable. This is a clear case of misuse of security law. I hope you are able to understand how laws are misused. Possibly this kind of knowledge will help you to apply your understanding in the examinations to identify whether a particular law is used in a right manner or it has been misused. Okay, I hope this is very clear. My dear students, this entire PDF will be available to you on protalentdigital.com. This is available free of cost. You can download it for your own enjoyment, for your own studies. Okay, if you like this video, please put a like button, subscribe to our channel, and tell to large number of people to be part of Pro Talent. Thank you very much and all the best.